The live stream video of the Christchurch terror attacks and the so-called manifesto, apparently written by the perpetrator, have been classified as objectionable. That means that distributing or even possessing copies of either of them is a crime under the law. Joining us to explain why is Chief Censor David Shanks. Kia ora, David. Thanks for being with us.
Kia ora, Jack.
I thought it might be valuable just to start by defining objectionable material. What does the law define objectionable material as being?
Sure. Well, we've got a Classification Act which sets out various criteria that we apply. So, for example, when we classify a paedophile how-to guide or a meth cookbook or a terrorist promotional brochure, we step through the Act in terms of whether this is presenting a harm to society and whether this is actually actively promoting crime.
Mm. Why then does the so-called manifesto count as being objectionable?
Okay, so we stepped this booklet. I don't think I would justify or credit it with the title manifesto. It's a terrorist promotional booklet. We stepped that document through the same process that we have stepped previous promotional publications from the likes of terrorist organisations such as ISIS. We took them through the same process. And essentially what you have here is a document that's promoting a hateful ideology. But going further than that, it's talking about specific targets, it's talking about specific means, and it's talking about specific justifications for carrying out atrocities and cruelty.
So that's what separates it from other hateful content that might be published on the internet, because I think we have all seen, you know, plenty of examples of racist content that has been published on the internet.
We absolutely have, and you can't stamp out abhorrent ideas through censorship. We're very clear about that, but there is a line, and the line is set when you are actively engaged and seriously engaged in persuading people to copy your lead.
Do you think that this thing has been written by this person? You don't want to call it a manifesto. This booklet has been written by this person with the intent of inspiring others to follow a similar course.
I think that's very, very clear from the evidence. And in terms of experts who commentate on previous similar examples, this is a known syndrome and pathology around this sort of crime. People will rightfully say, well, perhaps I should be able to read this thing to understand what happened. This is a very poor place to go to try and understand what happened. This is a specific document created for a very specific purpose and a very specific audience to create more mayhem and terrorism.
Like you say, though, there will be people who say these are just words. And by shining light on them, we can argue them, we can disprove them for the ridiculous content that they amount to.
Sure. And there's plenty of material out there, as you've just noted, where you can point to that example and understand this ideology. In this case, we've got a specific document that can be particularly harmful for its intended audience in this country. And that's not everyday New Zealanders. Most right-thinking people will read this and not be harmed by it, not be affected by it, not be influenced by it. Mm. It's not for them. It's not for you. It's for a target audience that is susceptible and vulnerable to that message, and that can be very dangerous.
My concern is that people who might be susceptible to that message will see this censorship and say, well, here it is, the government trying to shut down these ideas, the authorities that be are trying to shut down these ideas, and that it actually plays into a narrative that reinforces some of those messages.
That's right, and that's a risk. It's an unavoidable risk in these situations. And when we first reviewed this document, my initial reaction was, I don't want to give this credibility necessarily by banning it. I don't want to give this cachet and attraction. But at the end of the day, we have to do our job. We have to step this through the legal principles that we have applied before. And essentially, it's the responsibility of people to recognise that and to recognise the fact that they can't spread direct hateful messages which are exhorting people to kill and commit terrorism.
How many exemption applications have you received so far?
I don't know what the number is. I know we've received several, and we've accepted that there's going to be a number of reporters, academics, researchers, analysts who will have legitimate access to this document, and we will give it to them.
And what sort of punishments are available to anyone who doesn't who publishes this or shares this?
The punishments for republication or promotion of an objectionable publication can be very high. They can be up to 14 years imprisonment. Mm.
So this is possession is an offence as well?
Possession is a serious offence as well.
Okay. Thank you for your time this morning. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Kia ora.